So he was not a disciple at all. He was a demon. But general person take him like a bona fide disciple. So you should know. I know that some devotees have kept their disciples' name echo up there. But I think they are so ignorant. They should not keep their disciples' name or son dot name echo up there. This is not true bhakti. Guru bhakti, like Jiva Goswami, like Narottam Thakur, like others, they are Guru bhakti. Chetan Rupa Goswami is true disciple, true guru also. Those who are true disciple, they may be true guru also. Guru never makes any disciple. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati has told. A guru never makes any disciple. What he makes? All gurus. To whom they will touch, they will guru. And they say that we are not guru. So, Jahara Prasadi Bhai,
E
Bhavatari Vyaja.
Krishna Bhakti Hoya Jaha Vyaja.
After that.
Guru Maka Padma Vaikya Chitei Tei Khoriya Aikya. Here Sri Sri Narottam Das Thakur is praying that make the words that are coming from your lotus mouth one with my heart. Your heart and your words are one, so make my heart and your heart one.
No. The meaning is this, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chitete Kariya Aikya. You should take the Guru words in your heart. Don't take anything. And this will purpose the service. Arna Kariya Mane Asha. Let everything aside. But the order of my Gurudev, the teachings of my Gurudev, is everything. If I will do, bhakti will come, Krishna will be also happy all the life. Iti te kariya. One, I should must obey Gurudev. I listen Gurudev, the teaching of the Gurudev will make me to serve Krishna and Radha and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is the meaning of iti te kariya. You should know that Shastra Vani, Krishna words, Shastra words, are same as Gurudev. Sometimes we don't understand this fact, but really it is. If bona fide Guru is, his words are following all the Ved mantras, and the Krishna words all follow Gurudev. So, if there is Guru mercy, then there is the mercy of Krishna in all. Yahar jasya prasada
bhagavat
prasada jasya prasada nagati like this. And one strength that I must follow.
Unflinching faith. Unflinching faith.
Then what is?
Sri Guru Charane Rati. Rati.
Sri Guru Charane Rati.
Eise
Uttama Gati. Sri Guru Charane Rati. Seise Uttama Rati. What Uttama Rati? Rati to the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna and Radha. What Gurudev wants? He wants that you all should serve Radha and Krishna, conjugal or Chaitanya. This is it. When Gurudev will be happy? If you are serving Radha Krishna and Chaitanya, he is happy. Otherwise he will not be happy. By giving anything to him, he will never take anything. Only he wants. This is the manovist of Gurudev, to please Radha and Krishna. Only. then
chakshudana dila jai jai
chakshudana dila jai. I was so blind, so much pain, but Gurudev gave me
eyes.
Who get eyes to Narottam Thakur? Jiva Goswami and first Jiva Goswami gave, because he is Shiksha Guru. For Narottam Thakur, Jiva Goswami is more important than his Gurudev Loknath Goswami. So he is always trying to please Jiva Goswami, because he knows that to serve Jiva Goswami is to serve Loknath Goswami. That is why Narottam Thakur has told that when my Gurudev Loknath Goswami will come and take me, and he will offer in the lotus feet of
Rupa Goswami.
So we should try to understand the deep meanings and do accordingly. Only wordings will not do anything. I'm doing kirtan daily, 3 times, 4 times, and not obeying all these things, not doing. In fact, we'll be happy. We'll be sahajiya or anything more. So, let us begin from Guru service, obeying Gurudev. If Gurudev is bona fide, we should not think that whether his order is good or bad. I have nothing to worry to carry my order of my Gurudev, because I know that what he is telling is true to full extent. You have nothing to worry in the order of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami, because he is true to extent. So you must carry what he is telling. Don't think whether it is wrong or right. Nothing. He is not a Kanishtha Adhikari, he is not a Madhyama Adhikari, but he is
Vitarma.
Like this. Then?
Prema Bhakti Jaha Hityagya.
So, he will give us Bhakti Netra in this birth. After this one. Till we will not be liberated and will be in groups. He will always come and help. He has done pratigya. If anyone he takes his shelter, he never gives up. He never takes his honors or even very general mistakes. Always excuse. So it may be so many births. But yet he will help. And he will help up there. We have seen in Brihad Bhagavatamrita,
Sanatana Goswami,
that in 100 and lakhs births he helped his Dishai. So this is a very great hope for us. He will never, we may give him, but he will never give. Prema Bhakti
Jaha Hite Avidya Vinasa
Jaya. First Prema Bhakti will come by serving him, and every anarth will go away, offenses will go away. First our offenses will go away, and then Prema Bhakti will come.
No.
It is absurd. As much as Bhakti will come, it will be first Bhava Bhakti, then Prema Bhakti. And all kinds of anarth and offenses will go away. Otherwise not. If Bhakti is not there, and you are trying in lakhs and lakhs, but you cannot do. So we must try to serve Gurudev and to have some bhakti, and then they will go automatically, otherwise no. Don't try more to give up offenses and control mind and all these things. It will come out automatically if you are serving loyally to your Gurudev.
Dibya Gyan Hridaya Prakashito.
Dibya Gyan. All Gyan will come, Samandha Gyan, Avidheya Gyan, Devijan Gyan. Everything will come. So go on. So he is telling, Haha Prabhu Karadaya. Seeing no alternative at all. There is nothing alternative. Then weeping bitterly, weeping with tears, we should pray to Gurudev, telling that you are the manifestations of the Gurudev, Prabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. You are so much causeless, merciful. Be merciful to me. I am blind. Having so many anaths, Ah, Prabhu Karadaya, Padachaya, the shade of your lotus feet. Padachaya, Kuhapadaya. I am taking shelter, but I am not qualified to take shelter, but yet I am praying you to make me so that I may fully surrender. So we should try to do. Narottam Thakur has written a book,
Prarthana,
but very little book, containing so many
Prem Bhakti
Chandrika. And this is the Mangalacharan of this, in the beginning. At first there were not so many books. Only Bhakti Rasami Sindhu and all others. This is the purport of Bhakti Rasami Sindhu, Prem Bhakti Chandrika. And first Kirtan is this. Ekta Kirtan Karpish. Tata Mahi Vishan Kolevi Nabhara. Krishna Bandana.
जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री दशरथ गौर भक्त वृंद
चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यश्च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेम कृष्णाय कृष्ण गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदालय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय भक्त्या विहीना पराधलक्ष्यै क्षेत्राश्च कामादितरंग मध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृंदे नमस्ते चरणं तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे त्वं नमामि शरणं have told this shlok, Anarpita Charim Chirat. It was composed by Rupa Goswami in his Vidagdha Madhav. Very authentic book of Rupa Goswami. He was writing a book to fulfill the wishes of Srila Rupa Goswami, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he was coming from Vrindavan to Jagannath Puri in the way, in a village named Satyabhamapur. He has a dream in the last night. If anyone in the last night sees dream, and after that he don't again sleep, then it may be true. And for devotees who are so high class of devotees, their all dreams are true. Radhika's dream, Krishna's dream, devotee's dream, never falls. So he saw a dream that a very beautiful Divya Devi has come and telling me that don't make one book, make two books, one of Braja and another from for Dwarka. Don't mix. Then he began to make, he thought that Satyabhama is doing. Here is Satyabhama and he is dreaming me. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met him in Puri, he came to Puri. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told in a, any way, then don't take Brajanandan Krishna out of Vrindavan. That is, what is the meaning? You should not take this Krishna to Dwarka and Mathura. Tattvata, they are one. No difference at all. But by rash vichar, when the vision of rash, Brajendanandan and Vasudev Nandan are not same. They are different. But by tattva they are one. Ordinary person cannot take these things. Only if Madhyam Adhikari is there and he is the line of Rupa Goswami, he can understand these things. Rupa Goswami at once stored this, understood, and for one book he met this Mangalacharan. When he was in Puri, in the cottage of Haridas Thakur, he was so humble that he don't used to go on foot to take darshan of Jagannath. Always very far away, and from there he used to do Shastang Pranam. Because I am so wretched, I am Muslim, I have no quality, I am impure, like this. Rupa Goswami also followed Haridas Thakur. Because with Hishan Shah Muslim King, I am also like a Muslim. So he used to be there. One day, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came there with his all associates, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, Swarup Damodar, Raya Ramanand, all together. Very learned society conference. And they, Swarup Damodar, tell that what books are you are writing? Show me. He was so ashamed that he was not going to show these things. But they told repeatedly, so he gave it. Oh, you should recite the first slok, Mangalacharanam, Sarup Damodar told. He was so learned. He began to recite this. Anarapite charing chirat karunaya avatirna kalau samarapaitam unnato jalra sangsa bhakti hariha purva sundara dutika damba sandipita sada hridaya kandare spurutame sachinandana. No. All became so happy. How a beautiful, full of all kinds of siddhanta in this slok. We have never heard like this. We have heard so many things, so slow, but never heard like this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, it is not good slok. Three lines of this slok. It's so better, so better. But us purvatame sachinandanaha, it is like poison in milk. It has made wrong all things. Sarup Damodar told that this fourth line has made it as if in so much condensed milk there is campus or mishri there, sugar there. It has made it more tasteful. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told all, be merciful to Rupa Goswami, so that he may know my heart and he can fulfill my all desires. Now we are going to explain this sloka. Why Krishna Das Kaviraj took this sloka in Mangalacharan? He was so learned person, he can make hundreds of sloka in very little time, in moments. He has made so many slokas in Chaitanya Chaitamrita. He has made Gopal, Govinda Lilamrita, so... No. Himself he has done. Govinda Lilamrita. He has done about more than 1,000 slokas there. So many in... All a slok he has done, so many good books he has written. Why he took this slok? Because undoubtedly Rupa Goswami is Siddha Mahapurusha and he is Rupa Manjari. If he unko if he makes glorify Krishna and praise Krishna, he is probably more effectful, powerful than my. I am so ordinary person. I have no bhakti at all. So if the prayers of Narottam Thakur, Premananda, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, are the slokas of Rupa Goswami and all others, Sarup Damodar, we will recite. It will be more powerful than we will do ourselves. We should not do kirtan of other persons who are not qualified and who are not devotional persons. They can make so ornamented language in English or Hindi or Bengali or Sanskrit, but we should not sing. We should sing songs of authentic Vaishnavas. So he is taking and praying. By this praying, surely our Ishtadev will be so happy. Anarpit charin chirat. Anarpit means not given. Pachirat, for a long time, what has not been given? What is that long period? Long period, that in a Brahma day, it constants so many years. 3 lakhs?
4 lakhs.
32,000 years make Kali Yuga. Twice to this Dwapar, thrice Treta, and Chatur, four folded Chatur Yuga. All max 8 crore 32 lakhs. And same period, like Sandhya, evening. And all this
Cycle. 71 times
became one manvantar, and then into 14 manvantar again. Then it comes so many years. So in these years, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not come, and this unalloyed Unnata Ujjwala Rasa Bhakti Sri has not been given. We are lucky, so lucky that we have come. After only 500 years, after going Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers. I think that it will be 400 years after Rupa Goswami and Jiva Goswami. 250 years Narottam Thakur and Chakravarti Thakur. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, 100 years. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, when he, in 37, then how much now, to up till now?
60 years.
Only 60 years he has passed away. And it is only 30 years our Gurudev, and Swami,
20 years
only Swami, 20 years gap now. Siddhar Maharaj more nearer, 10 years. So we are lucky. So we should try to understand and follow all these things. If you are not doing following, then again it may be that lakhs and lakhs births will go away and no suitable time will come. So we will lose it forever if you are not trying for this. If you are going to bona fide going and qualified in this birth, then it may be that you will come after 200 years of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and after that birth you will go to that same planet where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is playing with his all associates. So we should try to understand all these things. You should not think that it is only propaganda, this shloka. We should try to know that it is bona fide to, as Krishna is himself. Now he is telling, Karunaya Vataranaha Kalau. In Kali Yuga, when 7 manvantar had gone away, seven Manu has, were changed, seven Indra were changed. In seventh, when 27 Kalijugs and Satyug Treta all were changed, in 28th Chaturjugi, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came with his all associate. Krishna came to this world. How? Why he came? Samarpayitum unnata ujjvala rasam svabhakti shriyam. This whole is one line. Samarpayitum, to give. What thing to give? Very precious and rare thing. Brahma Shankar, even Sukhdev Goswami, Narad Goswami, Shankar, they want to have this thing. But we think that they have not got it. What is this? They want this. Uddhava wants. Uddhava went to Vrindavan, you know? And he realized the glory of Nanda Baba Yashoda. He realized the glory of gopis, especially of Srimati Radhika. And he became so happy. But he became hopeless. We go to any mountain and see that Everest of India is about 30,000 feet so high. We cannot be like that, so high. No? So he came to Uddhav, came to Braja from Mathura. And he was saying, gopis, Nanda Baba Yashoda. He told, he saw that Nanda Baba is weeping, 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 thinking Krishna to be his son. He's thinking, how is this? Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, more than Narayan and Ram and all others. And he has come mercifully to Nand house and he has become like a son, but really he is not son of anyone. He is not son of Vasudev or Nand or Yashoda. But how it is a strange thing that he is thinking that Krishna is his son. Nand Baba is telling, will Krishna come? He remembers us. And he began to weep and loudly so. I want to forget Krishna. And for this I go to Jamuna, on the bank of Jamuna. But I see that there are so many trees, creepers and Jamuna itself, that they began to tell the history of Krishna. And remembers me. So again he comes and wants to console his heart and to forget Krishna, and he goes to Vrindavan. But all the trees are crying, crying, Krishna, Krishna. He went to Rashtra Lila Sthali, that is Banshiva. When he went to Bandirvan, when he went to Kalihrada, he went to Govardhan, to whom he lifted. All the places are crying, all the dusts are crying for Krishna. They remember me. I become. So, never taking any rest, always weeping. Buddha is telling that how fortunate they are, thinking Krishna, this Supreme Personality of Godhead, thinking merely very loving child, loving son, he told to Nanda Baba, "Oh, you and Yashoda are so fortunate that you are thinking Krishna to be your son and very affectionate to him, sometimes chastising him, sometimes bending him, his hands, rebuking him. Oh, you are so fortunate." Hearing this, Nanda Baba told Uddhava, "I thought that you have become so qualified in the association of Krishna, but I see that you are very ignorant, like anything, very ignorant. You have no knowledge at all. You are very foolish, no intelligence at all. You are telling me, so fortunate, who is most wretched in this world, that Supreme Personality of God had come to me, and he came, I could not please him, and he left me, and he went to Mathura. I could not die like Maharaj Dasarath, telling Krishna, Krishna. So I'm not a good father." And he began to weep bitterly. Uddhava is telling Jesa, "Oh, I have done wrong. Certainly, I'm foolish." He was the private secretary of Krishna. He was mantri means prime minister. He was servant. He was everything of Krishna. But now he cannot think that whether I have done wrong or right. I have come to console Nanda Baba, Yashoda, and all Brajavasi. And now they are weeping so bitterly. But I know that they are fortunate. This is not wrong. But I should not have told them that you should weep and weep for Krishna. If anyone is weeping for Krishna and one tear comes, then he is certainly a fortunate person. So Nanda Baba is weeping. So he is really a fortunate person. But Uddhava thinks that I have done mistake. I cannot tell him that you should weep more. Then how I can console him? So what should I do? I should say that, "Oh Nanda Baba, you are so fortunate, you should weep and weep bitterly." I cannot say. And I cannot stop him weeping. Because you know that all Shastra has told this, like this. What should I do? He became foolish at all, could not understand what to tell anything. This was a very critical position for Uddhava, who is our authority. And he became dumb at all. And what he saw there, gopis. In the morning, gopis are seeing Krishna. Uddhava, who is this person? Akrush has again come to this place, but he has taken to Krishna to Mathura. Now, what purpose is his purpose? To come this place? Krishna is not here. Why he has come, Akru? In same golden chariot. Oh, Krishna has sent in chariot, golden chariot. Why? He wants to make know gop and gopis that, oh, Krishna is not their son, Krishna is now become king of Mathura, emperor of Mathura. So this neglected servant, Akrur, he has sent on a golden chariot to show them, "I am not any cowherd boy," to show this. Understand? Not Krishna is now not so important, he is so important person, king of Mathura, not a cowherd boy, not poor, without shoe and without umbrella. To say his opulence, he has sent his servant like this. But I know, gopis are telling, who is he? One told that, I know. He is Shyam, but he is not Shyam. He is actually Shyam, mane? He has taken this
color
of Krishna, his everything, ornaments, pitambar, everything. And his color was also like Krishna. So he is black, but not that black, not Shyam, not Krishna. And seeing this Buddha, Srimati Radhika came in Mahabhav Dasha. And he began to speak with a
bumblebee.
Thinking him the dut of, messenger of
Krishna.
He has come drinking wine. Gopis are telling like this. Sometimes laughing, sometimes doing majak,
joking,
sometimes so much making guilty Krishna, so many things. Krishna has all tested separation mood and mating. He has tested Dasyaras, Sakhyaras, Shingar Rash, Madhur Rash. It has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam. Why Krishna came? He was in Golok Braja. There are two kinds of Braja. First you should know. There are two kinds of Braja. Golok Braja Vrindavan, Golok Gokul, Golok Vrindavan Braja Vrindavan, all there. And one in this earth, in this planet. What is that? Bhauma Vrindavan. Bhauma Vrindavan means?
Earthly Vrindavan.
Yeah. In this planet, there are lakhs and crore
universes.
Planets. Universe. We cannot count. Brahma cannot count. Even Brahma cannot count. Even Shankarsan, who is the father of all, creator of all, he cannot also. He may count. We may count. But anyone other cannot count. And all planets, there is a Braja. And that are called?
Brahma
Vrindavan. The real Vrindavan, Golok Vrindavan, always Krishna playing with his all
associates.
Srimati Radhika, Lalita Vishakha Chitra, Chandravali, Shyamala Bhadra, and all others. Dham, Siddham, Sudham, Vasudham, Sto Krishna, Lavanga, Arjun, Nanda Yashoda. Everywhere they are. Different growth in different planets. Also, at the same time being in Golok Vrindavan, they are also. And in all planets also. Not in all planets, but in all universe. Going like cinema reel. So, all the Braj, not different. They are one. They are,
Non-different?
Non-different, but different.
Achinta
Bheda Veda. Also manifestation of something. But all real, not unreal. If all the bridges of this planet are real, why we want to go there in Golok Vrindavan? If non-different, the same thing, why we want there to go? Why?
This is perfect
lila.
This is manifested and there unmanifested.
No difference in this. Difference is there. Very carefully you should note. Difference is there. That in this Vrindavan, Siddha, Asiddha, all can see the Krishna pastimes of here, in this Bhauma Vrindavan. Duryodhan also can see, but he will not see that he is Krishna. He will see that this is the son of any cowherd boy. Also Narada will see, and he is? Supreme Personality of God, he is Krishna, doing always pranam. But when he will go to Braja, Bhauma Vrindavan, Yashoda will come? No, here. In this Bhauma Vrindavan, in Gokul he will go, Yashoda will take his lal, his son, Krishna, and will fall in the flat of Narada Baba, and he will take the feet dust of Narada and tell that your feet dust will save Krishna. Narada is... What Narada is thinking? See this, strange. I should not make any problem for Krishna pastimes. Let it going on. I should not disturb. So he is fearing also, trembling also, and seeing the glories of Danda, Yashoda, Gopis everywhere. So in this pastime, in this Bhauma Vrindavan, Bhauma Mathur Mandal, all can go. Whether they are Siddha or not. But after some time, here, in 10 years, it will disappear, and we will not see here. But in Golok Vrindavan, only Siddha can go, though her prem, love, affection has been
perfected.
And forever they will go, and they will never return to this world. Anyone, any soul, Siddha, Kaibhuha, Nitya Siddha, if they will touch Krishna and go to that Golok Vrindavan, never, never, never they will be come to this. Because they will never be opposite to Krishna. Bimukh nahi ho sakte. They will be never opposite. They cannot forget Krishna. So there is no Maya. Maya is not there. Only Jog Maya is there. To make them
connected to Krishna.
Connected and always giving service to Krishna. So there is no chance of falling. So any conditioned soul has not come from that place, Siddha Bhumi. They have come from a Tatastha line, from Karnabdha Vishnu. So Krishna, to help the jivas and to bestow his causeless mercy, to samarpayitum, this is the explanation of samarpayitum, only one word, samarpayitum. What samarpayitum? What to give? He has come in a Brahma one day here in Bhauma Vrindavan.
Yes.
He has come in one day of Brahma. Why he has come? am in next trip, after 10-15 minutes, I will tell you something about this. One kirtan should be done. Kokhan dubar bolle. Aare takhon to bolle. Then, one kirtan? Tomorrow? Tell him to do, and you should do kirtan. Hari Bol. You should do kirtan. Oh.
What do you want to tell everybody?
Thank you.